right, ladies and gentlemen, this is a new cat here coming here to Mad Life Staging Studio. Really funny guy. Checked him out online. It's his first time here, and he's going to come out here and just break all your faces with laughter. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the stage, Mr. Scott Bogarts.
Hello, everybody.
Hello.
Let's keep it going for Chelsea one time. Let's hear it for Mad Life for having us all out tonight. And everybody, Falcons rise up! Glad they're playing the game somewhere that's nowhere near Boston. You had that guy that pulled the fire alarm in the Steelers hotel. Everybody hear about that this weekend? Guy pulled the fire alarm in the Steelers hotel at like 3:40 in the morning, throw them all off. Cops, they caught him, and the cops said, you know, why'd you do that? Said, you know, I was drunk, I was stupid, and I'm a Patriots fan. I heard that, I said, did you really need to say the first two things? Where's the tennis team? Captain, oh my captain! I was gonna get up on the chair and do that, but I have no coordination, no insurance, and a bad back. It's funny, Chelsea said, you know, when he heard tennis team party, he thought, I hope it's not like a bachelorette party, because bachelorette parties always interrupt the act. I was back in the back, I was thinking, I hope a tennis team party is like a bachelorette party, because, you know, they've usually got some crazy list of sexual dares, which is about the only way I get sex anymore, is on some kind of a dare, so fingers crossed later. So I kind of feel like I pandered a little bit there at the start with that Falcons thing, right? You know, I usually don't open like that. I just go ahead and open with a joke. That's ego, right? That's your ego just telling you you're better than you really are. Certainly my ego goes, damn it, you're a computer scientist, man. You're funny. You don't have to pander to them. You should be able to walk out on stage and just go, fuck you, motherfuckers. And they should still love you. But I understand there's money at stake tonight, so I went with the safer approach. A little bit about me. I'm Jewish. I know that's gonna be pretty surprising after I just said I'd sell out my principles for a few bucks. Something really unique though, I'm a Jew who was born in Biloxi, Mississippi. Yeah, you all get it, that's right. I used to have, instead of candles on the birthday cake, they had little burning crosses. People tell me I don't look Jewish. I say, that's evolution. Jews who look the part did not survive in Biloxi long enough to reproduce. I was driving up here tonight, I saw a truck, had the name of the business stenciled on it. Michael Jackson Landscaping. I said, that's odd. I thought he liked to do most of his work before there was grass on the lawn.
Oh! Ouch.
All right. So we like child molesting jokes. We'll go with another one then. Not another child molesting, just kind of the same vein. Everybody's seeing the news in North Dakota now. They're trying to pass a law where you won't be liable if you accidentally hit a protester with your car. That's an interesting one. I'm sure that the legislative aide that was working with the guy, with the senator, had to keep marking out engine and replacing it with protester. I kind of hope they bring that law here, though, because I'm not really a great driver. And in my experience, everybody becomes a protester right before they get hit by a car, right? They might not have a sign, might not be pumping a fist in the air, but they're like, no! So, you know, I don't want to lose another 7 years of my life if I can avoid it. Oh, that was crossing the line, running somebody over with the car. All right, so as long as I've crossed the line, I'm going to go into political material for just a second. Not really that political. You know, I haven't taken advantage of any of the golden comedy that Trump offered us over the past couple weeks. You know, I'm kind of encouraged by some of what I heard, actually. I go to the beach quite a lot. You know, I'm worried about the, you know, what's going to be covered in the new health plan, what's not going to be covered in the new health plan. So when I heard all that, it made me pretty sure that treatment for jellyfish stings would definitely be in. So I was very happy about that. No beachgoers. Treatment for jellyfish stings. Pee on them.
Hey!
All right. I was all right. Well, that's a setup for this joke. Okay. Dial it back. That's a setup. Because I'm not really going to, I don't want to pile on anybody, right? Everybody makes bad decisions. Let's give them a chance. I know I make bad decisions. I make an astronomical amount of bad decisions, which is really amazing given the number of bad decisions I've shot into a sock.
Oh.
I didn't know if it was the book club or, you know, frat night tonight. And I don't know what to make a tennis party, so. I have another joke where I make reference to a hydra and an amoeba. And then the punchline is that that's the only place in the country you'll get a joke with two protozoan references in it. So, but I didn't think that was going to work. So, next time for you. So I'll close with this. My dad. I love my dad. He's a great guy. Everybody knows. I don't know if everybody's dad is a great guy, but my dad's a great guy. But everybody's dad probably at some point has said something that, you know, crushes one of your dreams or takes away some of the pleasure in your life. You know, something like, Santa's not real.
What?
You're not good at comedy. You need to get a real job. I'm not your real father. Thank you for those who put together that I started with a joke about being a Jew and then included that that Santa line in there. Thank you for not pointing that out. But what my dad did recently is I'm a little pissed off at him. He kind of ruined one of my great pleasures in life, which is yoga pants. I like that fashion trend. I like you go to the gym. You go to you know, the mall. You go to a school bus stop. You see so much camel toe, you think you're on the set of the movie Ishtar. Was it the Ishtar reference? But my dad's reached a point where he just doesn't give a fuck anymore. You know, he wants to be comfortable. He doesn't care about anything else. And for some reason, his active wear is not comfortable enough for him, his sweatpants. So he's been browsing the web for some kind of sweatpants solution for himself. So we were together with my sister-in-laws and my wife, and my dad searching the web, and he comes up with this gem. He says to him, "Can I wear yoga pants?" So now I have that vision in my head. You know, every time I try to gaze in there and get that camel toe look and get a little happiness out of that, instead I see Squidward tentacles, which is really disturbing. Thank you very much, everybody. I'm Scott Bogart.